Hey there, estate planning attorney Paul Rabelais here again, and in this video, we're going to talk about whether the signing of your will and other estate planning documents should be videoed. All right, so here's the deal. Video is everywhere these days. From a legal perspective, you know, depositions are videoed. Heck, from a criminal perspective, many shootings these days are videoed. Thefts in department stores, they're all caught on video. Police wear body cams. And quite frankly, anytime something interesting happens and anybody's around, you're gonna see a whole bunch of people just immediately pull out their smartphone and start videoing. It's everywhere. And you know, the technology is really good and it continues to improve. I don't think video is going anywhere. I think it's gonna be around for a long time. By the way, this is my wife's cute case here. It's not my phone. So, and with the large number of estates being contested these days, you know, I think it was Dear Abby who said, if you really want to get to know somebody, share an inheritance with them. You know, when somebody dies, there's often this big pie that's out there. And for one reason or another, people who are entitled to a piece of the pie want a bigger piece of the pie. And then there's some people who aren't entitled to any of the pie. They want some pie. So there's lots of estates that are contested. Either, you know, the allegations being made often are the person who signed the will didn't have the required capacity to understand what they were doing, or a lot of estate contests where people allege that, hey, my father was influenced by you when he signed his will. That's undue influence. His will is invalid. Or some people contesting the fact that some validity requirements were not met. Maybe they are alleging that, you know, the witnesses didn't actually see the person sign the will, but they just, you know, signed on a witness line outside of the person who signed the will's presence. So, and then there's other reasons why people contest wills. So the question really becomes, you know, does it make sense to video the will signing? And there are perhaps some valid reasons to video, you know, the circumstances surrounding the signing of the will. Perhaps it can be better proven that the notary and the witnesses were present at the time that the person signed their will. But there's, quite frankly, there's a bunch of reasons not to video someone signing the will and the circumstances surround that. Because, you know, video can give a false appearance of health or nervousness or confusion. You know, anytime you put an old person in, maybe I shouldn't say old person, maybe I just say anybody, but quite frankly, most people who, you know, get serious about estate planning and kind of wonder whether things should be videoed. Most of them are older people. And when you put an older person in an unfamiliar location, like a lawyer's office, while that person is uncomfortable because they're in front of the camera and the lights, you know, really any stutter, any hesitation, any confusion as to things like, you know, the date that they're signing or where they have to sign on the documents, if that's all captured on video, it's likely to be used by the person who wants to challenge the will or the will's validity. So, you know, in my 29 years of doing this, I attempted, you know, one video of a person signing the will. It was a circumstance where the gentleman, his capacity was good, but he was just convinced that a certain person or two was going to challenge things when he passed away. And so he's like, I want my, you know, our signing and all the circumstances around it videoed. And so, you know, we kind of set it up, and before we turned on any cameras, he and I were having an excellent conversation, sharp as a tack. But as soon as we turned on those cameras, boy, he froze up and he messed up on what day of the month it was. Heck, quite frankly, I don't even know what day of the month it is right now. So, and he looked uncomfortable. He answered a couple of questions incorrectly. I said, nope, we're not going to do this. So we didn't do it. And that was just the one time I attempted it. in, you know, over 29 years, thousands, if not tens of thousands of me supervising all of these will signings. So in general, I'm gonna tell you, no, not a good idea to video the will signing. Let me give you a couple of other circumstances though. Some people might argue, well, hey, the fact that you didn't video that will signing, that must be some evidence that things are bad and you're trying to withhold, you know, some evidence. There's just no merit to that argument. I could see if it was common practice for estate planning attorneys to videotape all of their will signings, then maybe if they didn't, then that might be, you know, they're trying to hide something. But I don't know one attorney in this country or in this world who regularly videotapes their will signings. So, you know, it just it's not common practice. So there's not an appearance that you're trying to hide something if you don't videotape the will signing. Now, I will also mention in a related context, in my state, Louisiana, during COVID, our governor signed a proclamation where notaries can notarize documents by video. They don't have to be in the same room. However, that proclamation or that order excludes the signing or notarization of wills and trusts and donations, so forget about that. And then another little side note, there's a few states, and Louisiana is one of them. I think we did it in 2007, where we provided a statute that says the videotape execution of a will can be admissible in court if a will is contested. But I've never seen anybody use it. It's a cumbersome statute. The person signing the will has to take an oath on videotape by a person authorized to take oaths. And there are some other requirements that make it just cumbersome. I'm not saying that statute has never been used by a lawyer who needed or wanted to videotape a person signing a will. I just don't know of anyone who's ever done it. And if it was commonplace, I would have heard that at least one person took advantage of that. So we don't see people using that statute. Now, there's some other circumstances where people have wanted and kind of insisted the use of videotape. Just a couple of days ago, I was talking to a gentleman who I'm working with to help him get his estate legal affairs in order. What he said he was gonna do, and I don't even know that I could talk him out of it, he was so, you know, adamant about it, was after we get all of his estate legal documents customized, signed, you know, notarized, witness, all done, then he's going to arrange to have maybe a kind of little meeting or at his house, and all his kids are going to be there. And he said he's going to pull out the GoPro and he's going to record, you know, what his explanation of what he's done, and maybe even more importantly, why he did what he did. He wanted his kids, his family to understand the reasonings behind, you know, what he and I are working together to build for his family in that transition to the next generation. So that is going to accomplish two things. One, it's going to communicate in person the why he's doing what he's doing to his children, which I think is a great idea. And then second, he's going to have that on videotape. So maybe 10, 20 years from now, if the kids want to revisit that and take a look at that, that might better refresh their minds as to why he did what he did. Maybe that's a good thing that he's videoing that family meeting. Maybe it's not, you know, well, I guess the future will tell. So I would say every circumstance is unique, but the general rule is no video in the signing of the will, the trust, the powers of attorney, all those, you know, customized estate legal instruments. No video often does more harm than good. But again, like I say, every circumstance is unique. But what I would recommend is that, highly recommend, however, that you smash the like button. That tells the YouTube algorithms, show Paul's videos to more people. So maybe other people won't make the mistake of videoing their will signing incorrectly. And then the other suggestion, if you haven't done already, you know, heck, why not? It's free. Hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. That way you won't miss anything in the future. because I hope you enjoy watching these videos as much as I enjoy making them, because I got a lot more content to share and create. And goal here is to enable you to do what you need to do, have peace of mind that you've protected yourself, protected your family. We'll see you next time.